Hey guys, how you all doing? How you all doing? Now, I'm thinking. Someone said that the Shield is the best. Said it on social media. So I said, best at what? And that was hours ago. And he hasn't replied. What devices, streaming devices, do you guys recommend? Alright, and why? And he said the Shield is the best at what? Is the Shield something that you guys will recommend to your family and friends to get? Because I haven't. I remember when it came out in 2015, I was looking at it. At the time, I decided to spend my money on on a box called Hi Media. And I think I actually bought three of them. And the one that I bought, you can actually put a hard drive that had all your files and stuff like that inside of it. So you open the lid, slot your hard drive in there, is it 3.5 or 2.5? It just slots in there, close it, and then you can play back your media. Now on that device, you actually had its own media player as well. And then it had Kodi on there, but you had to install an extra, what they call it, a wrapper. A wrapper on top so you can play. And I remember at that time it was Kodi 15. So 2015, Kodi 15. Yeah, Kodi used to come out every year. And it was okay, but I wasn't too sure about the Shield. I think at that time it was more to do with, sort of gaming, wasn't it? They wanted to launch some gaming platform, and when you could buy the Shield, then you could actually get their controller as well as that remote control. Jeez, look at that car. So, and as you can see now, it's changed. So, Shield came out in 2015, then 2 years later, it came out again, 2017, and then it came out again in 2019. Now, I think a lot of people were disappointed with the 2019 model because it didn't come with a controller. It did come, it did come with a new sort of remote control, and then it said about the AR upscaling and the support for Dolby Vision. Now, I know that not everyone who had the 2015 or 2017 Shield went out and bought that. Which way do I go? Went out and bought the 20. Damn, I should have got another one. So, went out and bought the 2019 Shield, and I was thinking, do I do that or not? Reason why? Because my TV already had Dolby Vision, and my TV is a smart TV, so it has those apps already installed, like Netflix, etc., which have Dolby Vision, etc. And that was one thing the 2017 Shield didn't have, support for Dolby Vision. It had HDR. Anyway, I bought it anyway. But and now you buy it and you use a lot of money. Compare, and at the same time, I'm still buying the Fire TV devices like the Fire Stick and the Cube. And to be honest, guys, the Cube, right, even up to now, the second gen Cube, to me is probably the best device out there for all around use, because I still use it and I don't sell it anymore. And I remember I bought it brand new for £60. Bought it brand new for £60. I think it was probably, I don't know if it was 50 or 40 on top of that. Nah, it would have been about 70 or £30 on top of that, wouldn't it? Yeah, would have been about 70 or £80. I can't remember what the full raw price is, but I use it now to make builds on, test Kodi builds, and to test out movie apps. And to be honest, it's perfect for what anybody wants to do, to use. And I've never said to my mates, yeah, come buy a Shield, yeah. And all they want to do is watch their, them little apps. So what's the point of spending so much money on a Shield just to watch those apps? If you wanted to use the Shield for, I don't know, as a Plex server, connect multiple hard drives to it, What else? Yeah, it's you can use it for like a time shifting, you know, PVR. You can use it for that if a shield. If you want to do stuff like that, or even like the big gaming stuff, then yeah, the shield. But most people don't. They just want sort of like a fire stick. We could just plug it in, use the remote control, and there you go. And now in America, they got these other boxes, isn't it? On boxes and stuff like that you hear about. And like, we can still get sort of these other sort of Chinese boxes in the UK. But let's get out of this area. Yeah. So what devices do you recommend? If the shield is that great, why? Let us know. Would you still buy a shield now? Even though they haven't been maintaining it. They haven't released an update in like 18 months. You know, there's no talk rumors about releasing another model. The Hotfix they issued to those Hotfix users, was it over a year ago probably? They've never made an official release for it. So I know, well, I don't know. I also had a box called Minix. Now I checked their website, the UK, I guess, and they don't no longer do any Android boxes, so they do these like mini PCs. So maybe mini PCs are the way to go, but you know, everything is just for time. You know, nothing lasts forever. There's always changes, etc., etc. Anyway, guys, I need to concentrate on my driving now, but I'll let you guys go. All right, thank you very much. Thank you very much.